Hi everyone and welcome to the new video. My name is Dimitri and I work as an embedded software developer. In this video I will show how to use a Heltek V4 LoRa module with a Meshtastic network. Meshtastic is an open source off-grid decentralized radio network. It is a cool stuff and it is interesting to see how it works. In this video I will make a short unboxing. I will show how to configure and write a firmware and how to send and receive messages. Without further ado, let's get into it. Okay, let's see what's in the box. So we can have this Heltek module. As we can see, it's pretty small. It is based on ESP32 board. It has a small screen. The button names are a bit confusing. This button called programming, but actually in Meshtastic it's used as a user button. And this is the reset button, and these are all the controls. Also, we have this small antenna that I will connect. We have a GPS module and two connectors, one for optional lithium battery and second optional for solar power. So technically you can make a solar power node from this. First, there is an important note: before powering the board and writing the firmware, you need to plug the antenna, otherwise you can burn the transmitter. First, I need to gently push this connector. It's pretty small, but it's easy. As we can hear, it clicks, and now we have the antenna connected. As we can see, this antenna is pretty small, but it does the job. But if you want a better antenna, you can buy it separately. Then optionally, we can connect the GPS. It's also easy. The connector is at the bottom. And now let's turn it on. Okay, when the board is connected, we can flash the firmware. And to do this, we need to go to flasher/meshtastic.org. There are two important notes. First, it works properly in Chrome, so browsers like Safari or, I don't know, Internet Explorer will not work. In your system settings, this board must be detectable as a serial port, as a USB serial, of course. We don't use physical serial ports anymore. So you can open your system settings and verify that the port is available, because without port, this tool will not work, obviously. So if nothing works, check the USB settings or check your computer and cable. For example, I had two Meshtastic boards of the previous generation, and it turned out that from three cables, two are not working. So when the cable is connected and device is detectable as a USB port, you select the target device. And for our board, it is obviously Heltek. We scroll down and this is Heltek V4. This is the latest board at the moment of writing this video. Then we can select a version. There are different versions like alpha or beta. I am selecting the latest beta. And now we press flash and technically that is it. Here we have the change log. And as a precaution, I'm doing flash firmware, so I'm sure that the board is completely new. This is my port. As we can see, it is available on the screen. Okay, 5 minutes later, it turned out that I get an error because I already wrote the firmware before. In this case, I need to plug the board again while holding the programming button. Then the board runs in the programming mode without active firmware, and I can try again. As we can see, the port name changed, which is a good sign. Board is in the programming mode. Normally, you don't need to do it for a new board, but I already programmed it before. So technically it is easy, but if it is a new board, you don't need it. But you may need it if you want to upgrade the firmware, of course. So it's good to know how to do this. And the process is done. Let's test our board. So I disconnected the board from the computer and let's turn it on and I will show how to pair it. This board has only two buttons, a reset button and programming button. The name can be a bit confusing, but the programming button is also a user button. There is no joystick here, so we can use this button. I can use it to navigate the menu and long press use to confirm this, so it is easy. Then I am selecting the frequency. I live in Europe. As we can see, it's separating long list. And then I use long press to confirm. And the board is restarting now. And here we can see a new available device. Now I can enter this code, as we can see on the screen. So now we're connected to the network. And we can navigate this board using this programming button. Here I can see different nodes. I am using this test in the apartment, and of course there is no GPS lock because GPS needs an open area, so I can put it near the window. And we can see all the menus, we can see the configuration. And we are ready to go. Now let's see how we can send and receive messages. Interestingly, most of Meshtastic devices don't have a keyboard, so it is designed to be used with a phone companion, which is technically a good thing, so people can use it like WhatsApp or Telegram, so no special knowledge is required. This off-grid network can be good for hiking, for example. You can just buy a small device, you can put it in the backpack, and then you can just walk and communicate with other people in your group. Interestingly, the phone is only using a Bluetooth connection, so it can be even used in the airplane mode, doesn't need a cellular network. So practically your phone is only used as a Bluetooth keyboard. And the radio communication itself has a pretty long distance, the message can be sent to several kilometers. And now I will connect two devices and let's see how it works in practice. Okay, at this moment we configured two boards and I will show how the radio communication works. So I am plugging this board. This board at the left is probably 2 or 3 years old. This board is still available and it's a good one for testing. It also has a GPS antenna, it has a battery holder. So here we can see some progress in board's development. This board is probably 2 or 3 years old and this is a new one. Now I have two boards connected. One board has an ID EASC and second board has an ID B62C. I can find this node in my list. So here in the app I can see the list of nodes visible in my location. As a reminder, this is a mesh network, so it is not global, it not relies on internet. These are the real nodes that are visible in this place. And here in the app I can select a node and I can select direct messages we can see on the screen. As a short reminder of how it works, this phone is actually works only as a Bluetooth keyboard. All the communication is done by the radio module. So I can select a node and I can send a message, but message is sent by this small board. So let's do it. And as we can see, it works. I can also use button to switch between messages. So I see this message on the screen here. I can also send another message, well, like 1, 2, 3, 4, and watch the screen. I will also briefly show how to configure the node. So I need to select the node first. It takes some time to get the data. Now I can go to the configuration. Here, for example, we can see the node name. Here we can see messages that I am using for testing. Another interesting option is position. In the position we have two options, or we can have a physical GPS like this. It makes sense if you want to travel with this board, but if you want to use it at home, you can just enable fixed position and can just enter the coordinates. For example, if I type it like this, I can set latitude, longitude. Other parameters are mostly default, you can check it on your own. And that's it for this video. Thanks for watching. I hope you learned something new. I am planning more videos about Meshtastic. I'm going to make more outdoor tests. And I also tested the Python SDK for Meshtastic. It will be cool to see how it works. So feel free to press like and subscribe to see more content like this. You are also welcome to visit my Patreon page. You may get early notifications about new videos and access to the source code for some projects. Thanks for watching and see you next time.